have 6 minutes total.
Okay, thank you very much. Now I'd like to call this meeting to order. Councillor Bailey, your comments have been done to the fact that I started and Minister, I hope as well. And I hope now that we can just continue the meeting as we're down the agenda instead of you. Thank you. Okay. Do you have any apologies?
Could you possibly put the microphone on,
can't hear
a
word.
You can't hear nothing here, thank you.
Through your chair, there are a few of these applications that have come through that I'm aware of some of the people I'm working on that are involved in them. So I don't have specific declaration of interest, but just a general, I do know people that have come.
Thanks for that. My understanding is this is Wallasey life, it affects everyone, and all of us at some point or other are knowing people who are involved, I wouldn't think the special interest break that far.
I've got to say one thing to do with that. I am on the London board for the early years.
Thank you. Adrian.
Matters relating to Central Park.
Matters relating to Central Park. Is there any more? Right. Okay, thanks very much. Can we approve the minutes from the 17th of September?
Yes.
Is that agreed? Thank you. Okay, agenda item 5, your Wirral policy, pages 15 to 34. Have you never speak to this before? Okay, so you both get to please.
This report sets out bids that have been made to your Wirral, which is a joint development between the council and Magenta Living. And as there are more than 9 elected members here tonight, Chris Wirral Group has decision making powers tonight. So this report seeks decisions on the applications that have been made. The fund was launched on the 4th of August. £50,000 was made available to Wallasey Constituency and applications and advisors from the voluntary and community sector for bids of up to £2,500. 2.2 of the report sets out the 7 themes that the bids must have met, either one or more of them. The fund is to remain open until it's spent, but cut-off dates are advertised to allow the respective constituency committees to make the necessary decisions about awarding funding. And the first round closed on the 12th of September. 31 applications have been received, seeking a total amount of £69,733.52. And each of those applications are summarised in Appendix 1 of the report. The final column in Appendix 1 set out a scored assessment that's been undertaken of each application against the set criteria. So that is the impact of the proposed bid on the themes, the evidence of need, how it will measure success, and an assessment of value for money. I'd like to draw members' attention to the bid with the number YW27. The guidance states that, amongst other things, that the grants will not be awarded for the payment of salaries or wages. This application seeks funding in part for a support worker post. So the recommendations are that the working groups make decisions on the applications that have been submitted. If there is any funding remaining after those decisions have been made, that the fund is re-advertised on the 3rd of November with a further cut-off date of the 19th of December. And could I suggest that the representative from Magenta Living, who is Dominique Reed, is invited to join me to obtain.
Any questions from them both?
Mr. Chairman, just a question for Caroline. When you say it's called the evaluation condition criteria, who carried out that evaluation?
I did.
Okay.
Yes.
Right, you did have this when we met on the previous week in September. And these evaluations can be challenged at the time and have been passed as well. Just as a look at that.
Jim, I just think from an opposite point of view, it should be the tax commission tomorrow and I'm going to tell everybody.
Right, with your agreement, I would like to chair this meeting in the same format that we did on the 17th of September, which is to take each bid individually, give a very brief summary of what it is. I'm assuming everyone's read this. What we did last time, with some bids, it was quite obvious we got an agreement, we didn't have to go to vote, and we just said agreed on that. If there's any that are causing debate or whatever, we can question that and we tend to at the end. And also I'd ask Caroline if you could keep a run on top of the bids that we've agreed so as we know exactly where we're up to. And if we do reach out, then please let us know. Is that okay as a format for everybody?
Great.
Okay. Paperwork's quite cumbersome, so try your best to keep it. YW1. This okay, this is a bid. Right, YW1 from Stick and Step. They put in a bid for £1,200 with charity based on this card. I'll put it over to the floor. Is there any comments on this?
Jeremy, just a question, basically, as it goes on to all of them, not particularly this one. When it's got the number of people to benefit, are we talking about the number of people to benefit within the Wallasey constituency? Are we talking about the number of people to benefit across the board?
Caroline?
I'm not sure that all the applications have specified that. The bulk of the benefit will be the Wallasey constituency. But if groups, for example, have membership from wider areas, they can include those in the figures as well. But isn't it explicit enough to break that down in
example? Just going back to many of us, when we used to be involved in funding and I think funding, we always asked for postcodes to be some things to be involved in order for me to see as many spent in water. Do you not think that would be a positive thing to do?
And the future you can say what to say postcode.
Well, we used to use that postcode, we said we used to be involved in sort of to see if it being allocated. I mean they have two wards.
Yeah.
They both go to the place, two wards in the area of the we have six wards now across policy, one asking for every recipient.
As a postcode, so as we know it's within the heart.
And why should the decisions of one request or they have as a policy for it?
That condition hasn't applied within the other constituency areas either. The bids do specify where the group is based and where the bulk of the benefit will be. My observation would be that actually need doesn't necessarily recognise geographical boundaries in the same way as we do, so there may very well be some residents who will benefit who might not be within the Wallasey boundaries, but the same will also apply for funding from other constituency areas. So we do discourage rural-wide bids for exactly that reason. It's something that we can look at for the future, but I think that you can be confident, and when we monitor and evaluate in the way that we will, how this funding has been spent and how it has benefited local people, we can make sure that that's part of the evaluation.
Just a comment on something that Emma said. It's my understanding that even though the other three constituencies may not do it like that, each constituency makes up its own individual ways of working. Therefore, it really doesn't matter what the other constituencies are doing, they're not the same.
Christine?
Thank you, Chair. Yeah, I think that by and large, I think it's about having a common sense approach to this and you know, we don't want to stymie the group with you know, needless bureaucracy around individual postcodes of every single person who may or may not benefit from one of, in this case, 30 schemes. You can see how quite quickly that could tie things up. So I think we have to be kind of guided by the emphasis on this one.
Personally, I think if it was the case for postcodes, it's for the applicants to provide the information where the people come from, that they benefit. Of people within another constituency, then after
organisation like Stephen Staff, the cost bound is difficult to say where people could. I think I've got questions within the bit, not about the bit, just within the bit, and whether we have wish to contain the elements of that as part of their bit, or if actually I do recognise that you can't pin them down if the volunteers could come from any area. Apple could still be working in a different area. It's got what the needs of the charity are, the parents of the needs of what we think should do. But there are obviously bits in here that are predominantly different areas, and that's the one that I would like to support. But in the context of this, you have to take each one on its own merit, and then understand that, you know, sometimes you can't be prescriptive about a particular person living in a particular area, but they're probably drawn from a wider area. Can we work a wider area? It's about the actual organisation themselves. And I've got questions about just do our part of their bit, and whether we should be paying for that bit for the flow. It's one of my issues, and that, you know, I've got a problem with paying, you know, supporting volunteers and funding that aid, whether we should be supporting an advert in a paper that I think should provide us for free for, as opposed to us funding as they are a charity. So,
Next one, Mr. Moore.
I suppose it depends on how you identify the postcodes, because both CH41 and CH49 are in Wallasey constituency. So you're excluding, you can put all of CH49, all CH41 in? You couldn't if you put CH41 in, because it's people in Seaton with CH41 postcodes. It's people in Upper Kissel.
I think the spirit of the suggestion was we've identified that this was within our constituency. Let's see not be wondered down. We can always look at boundaries, we can have that discussion online. But we have to make progress. What I'd like to do now is go into the bid. They've asked for £1,200. I want to put that to the floor to see whether we agree or not before we do, for people to make comments on the suggestions.
Yeah, I've given you the concern that I've suggested to people that I need to be looked at. So it's £1,200 and we're going to go to the big lap on my suggestion.
So therefore, if we're going down that route, should it be for one of those?
I think we can get one of them.
Okay.
Could I make a suggestion? Because I understand the spirit of what's being suggested, but we'd be happy for the press office to provide support for the charities and alternative. Because my experience of the Wirral Globe is actually it would probably provide that support in an editorial form instead, and we'd be happy to work with the group to look at how we can achieve that form without them taking out an advertisement.
Adrian.
Chair, on that basis, and having seen firsthand what Stephen said, and my inclination is to give them the money they asked for, with the comments that Emma Davis made, I think that changes the position as far as I see it. So I thought I'd say give them an excellent organisation that does brilliant work.
I don't doubt the organisation, I don't doubt they do brilliant work for whatever it works out. But the councillor Ali was suggesting that we don't do even know about this. And Emma was suggesting that the press office work with them to create publicity in an editorial, then they don't need the £1,200 because they don't need that £806 element. £16 if it's going to be done through the council, through the press office, through an editorial, then I fully support the council having then suggested we move forward with that.
Okay, we need to make progress on this. We've got two figures that have been put to the floor, which is £400 from Councillor Abbey and it's £1,200. So I'm going to put this to the vote and then move on to the majority. Those in favour of giving the full amount of £1,200? Thank you. And those in favour of the £400? Okay, we had a majority, that went for the 1,200, that's what we're voting.
Okay, having that chair, can we then not waste council officers' time in producing editorials, stick his debt, as I have in all the other habits?
Well, that's another issue, we're just going to deal with it.
No, that was all
fair today.
That was all fair, so we don't want to ruin it.
Okay, going on to, sorry, YM2, digital and IT skills for employability. They were bid in £2,485 from the mayor applying for each of the outcomes following the pillars. Again, I'm going to put this up to the floor for comment. Councillor Abbey, Councillor Foley.
Seems to be a bit of a bridge, but I'd like to keep questioning earlier around refreshments. We don't pay for the element that's in there that says marketing, recruitment and training. You know, the position we should be funding, I have no problem with the bid itself, it's the element within the bid that I do question. And I just, you know, I want that down to market again. Well, I don't question that anything in the bid. What it delivers. I just think some areas that we are not, we should be responsible for funding for supporting the funds.
Thank you, Councillor Fraser.
I actually agree with Councillor's comments. My question is how to identify the training, obviously the way to do it is marketing. I'm not sure that's the plan that this funds allows, but I agree with the comments just made.
Okay. Would anyone like to give us a suggestion on what should be for the board on this, or should we return to this at the end?
I'd like to return at the end for this one.
Apologies, Chair, just an alternative suggestion. We could refer this to the council's own skills team to assess whether this is a gap. And the appropriateness of whether this will fill the need and report back to constituency committee, if that would be helpful.
Would that be helpful?
Very helpful.
Yeah. Okay, third bid, Wallasey Cricket Club. You've asked for the full amount, £2,500. And my understanding of the bid is to maintain the current mower. Is there any comments from the floor, please?
It's not a lot, it's towards a percentage of it. I've got the paper right, it's towards a percentage because you can use the old mower as a trade in, so part exchange with some support, some funding to support it. But I don't, because what it doesn't add up, and I thought it would be a bit of it's £47,000 for a new mower. Yeah. The cost of how we might get that £47,000, even with our new money. So it just said it was a trade in the old one. I don't know what the value of a trade in was, I suppose, and what percentage we're paying, what percentage the organisation was. It's a bit running around, isn't it? Maybe it's going to have to. Just not sure on that.
That's the reason.
I'm not sure where you're getting to. Where's
£47,000?
It's £4,900.
40,077 pounds. New exclusive with that.
Okay. What I was going to say is that I would support this bid because I know that the board's responsible for the ground is for the council, and they are responsible. I know in the past I know they've had difficulties maintaining it, so I would be supportive.
Okay, are there any more comments on this bid? Right. Ron, you said that you wouldn't have a breakdown. Do you think there's a figure that you'd like to propose that maybe we can get some on this?
Half which? 1,000.
Okay, we've got two figures. First one, for the full amount of 2,500. Those in favour? And those in favour of Councillor Abbey's suggestion of giving them half the money, £1,250. That's carried. Okay, number four, New Brighton Baptist Church, the Memorial Garden. Again, they must for the floor. Matt, comments from the floor, please.
Yes, Chair. At the Bright Ideas meeting, I know that there was a similar bid. I'm just asking the officers to just give us a clarification that this organisation that moved the Bright Ideas for me, as well as that we're coming with us now, that the bids are different things or complementary things within this project. If they aren't, then I think it needs to be withdrawn on the grounds that I think we did award some money for them to the Bright Ideas Fund. But if not, we need to just have some clarification.
My understanding is that it's
right, okay. They've asked for the full amount of 2,500. How do you feel on that?
I'm a little bit concerned by the Councillor's criticism.
In terms of moving things forward, would you like to commit subject to as being sure that we cross-reference both bids?
Yeah, is that agreed?
Yeah.
So we are committing the full amount subject to the outcome of what's investment. Right, thank you. New Brighton Gymnastics Club, Flip Flack for All, again, £2,365,000. Is there any comments from the floor on this one, please?
I'd just like to ask Caroline for a clarification on this. This is our gymnastics club. I was under the impression that the people that go pay for our session or whatever it is. If there is a payment made, is the company's equipment through that?
The only information I have is the information that's been for you. I don't know whether the group are here tonight, so maybe they're able to answer the question.
Are the group here tonight?
Point of information, they actually are offering free classes, so they don't pay, so that's why they need the money.
Right, okay, so they're offering free classes on this.
Yeah.
Okay. The bid is £2,365. Are we agreed, or does anyone think that is too high, or
agreed?
Yes.
Right, thank you. Number six, Amy and Friends, My Time to Be Late. They've asked for £2,500, and they hold a weekly group called My Time to